So Leslie, you brought up the T word, trust. I mean, did you trust each other right off the bat? How did that work?
Oh, the first day. Kent is so open and he's such a positive person. And in a town where negativity can rule and it can be a big part of, as my husband calls it, the business of music instead of music business. When you come in and sit down with Kent, first of all, you're in a beautiful setting. His home is up on this cliff, looks out all over Nashville. So you feel like you're in the clouds to begin with. And then he just has this really positive thing that he lays out. And we've even co-written with some other people, just like writers, younger writers, other writers. And they'll go off down the negative road and Kent always steers it back. And that has been, to me, it's one of the main threads through our relationship and through our songs, the positivity that Kent brings.
Yeah, that positive energy makes such a difference. I think it was back in 2016. In January, I made a New Year's resolution, which is not something I would normally do because, by the third week of January, I've, dropped my diet or whatever else it is. But this one I have stuck to and renewed it every 7 years, which is only to work with people who give me positive energy. And so it's
That's a good
fascinating.
one.
Yeah,
Well,
right?
and that's one of your questions was how do we tr choose co-writers? And you never know how it's going to be with somebody the first time. I always laugh and say, like, it's a first date only, you probably don't kiss. But that you just know people that have the chemistry that works with you, and then there's other people like maybe it is the lack of positive energy that you get from them or whatever. But I just love to write with the people that bring that magic when we're together. And I don't care how big or how small you are or what your hits have been or not. If I don't feel that, then I really don't feel the need to keep working with them because it's just going to be like hitting a wall. And I remember a friend in Nashville, when an artist gets a record deal, the record company or the publisher starts telling you who to write with. It doesn't matter who you wrote with to get where you are. And it's at its peak right now how they do that. But the one young guy got a record deal, and we've been writing for about 3 years, and he called me up one day and said, "What do you do if you keep getting with a certain person or two, and all of a sudden your stomach starts hurting and your head starts hurting?" Yeah,
I
you
said,
quit
"I quit writing with him." He
writing
said, "You can do that?" I said, "I can do that. I don't know if you can do that, but that's kind of how I approach things is, do I really love writing with this person? And is there magic there when we do, whether songs get cut or they don't, and we have fun? I mean, that's kind of what it's all about to me.
And Heidi, you know how that old saying, like we just said it the other night when we watched something on TV at my house, you know that old saying, like, well, I can't get that 2 hours back. When you've done something for like 2 hours and you're like, oh, I wish I hadn't have done that. Now, Kent and I both, and I've learned this from Kent also about cutting loose, kind of not dead weight, but just things that don't work, co-writes that don't work, even friendships that don't work, wish them well and move along down the road. Because we've started writing, like, we'll write with somebody, and if it doesn't work good, they'll be like, should we get back with them? And we'll be like, nope. That's 4 hours we can't get back, So we're just like, as we're getting older, it's just time is so much more precious. I think we have to be guardians of our time, stewards of our
A good
time.
way to put it. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.